You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk all about AI solutions with TTS Avatar and Azure OpenAI with my friend Sanyu. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're talking all about AI solutions with TTS Avatar and Azure OpenAI, a two-parter with my friend Sanyu. How are you doing, Sanyu?
Yeah, very good. How are you, Seth?
I'm great. Why don't you tell us who you are and what you do?
Yeah, so usually I say my name is Sanyu. It's very nice to meet you. So I'm part of the Azure AI platform team. So my role is to drive the go-to-market and also adoption of some of the Azure AI services. So one of them is TTS Avatar. So I also do document intelligence as well as Azure Computer Vision.
Oh, that's amazing. So why don't you tell us, I put your slides up. Why don't you tell us about Azure AI Speech, TTS Avatar?
Yeah, absolutely. So first of all, many of you have already heard about the Avatar for a long time, right? So the Avatar will fall into three different categories or three different buckets. So the first bucket is the cartoon type of avatars. And this is usually the 2D or two-dimensional. So if some of you have already used Microsoft Teams, right? So we allow you to create the avatars. So this is through the Microsoft Mesh technology. And then the second category is the 3D. Meta-human. Some of the 3D will look more like cartoons, and some of them will look very much like humans. Some will look really sophisticated. And then the third bucket is a two-dimensional real human avatar. And so this is where our Azure AI Speech, TTS Avatar product will fall under.
I see. So just for clarification, this particular service falls all the way to the right where real like human 2D models.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right. Let's keep going.
All right. Before I introduce the service, I just want to take you from the back, a scene perspective, how usually the avatar can be created. What is the workflow, right? So first of all, you have a body of text that you want the avatar to speak, right? So it could be natural language text, or could be in a speech. A synthesis markup language, right? So it's pretty much like a those markup language. And then the text will come into a module called the text analyzer. What the text analyzer does is basically putting the text into phonetic sequences. And the phonetic sequences can be further feed into the downstream. So the next step is doing the audio synthesis, right? So this is where our text-to-speech and also custom neural voice a model will come in to actually do the audio synthesis. So once the audio part is finished, the next step is doing the human appearance. So that's where the real avatar piece will come in. So behind the scene, it is using the service that I'm going to introduce in a couple of seconds.
Okay, so just for clarity, this is like two different models. One is text-to-speech with custom neural voice. We've done some shows on that. But then it's also... is it mapping the face to the actual words as well?
Yeah, absolutely. We have the technology called the lip sync, right? So basically, we make sure that the lip will actually sync with the language that the avatar will be speaking.
This is amazing. Can you show us how it works?
So the service, the official name is called Azure AI Speech, Text to Speech Avatar Service. This is under our Azure AI Speech portfolio. So we have two different offerings. The first offering is called the pre-built avatar. And then the second offering is called a custom avatar. So pre-built avatar is we have a couple of pre-built avatars already ready for you to use out of the box. And then a custom avatar is where you can actually build your own avatar. Usually we require 10 minutes or more videos from you. And we do have instructions for you how to record those videos to make sure it has the best results. And so the avatar is triggered by two different ways. One is the text input, the other is the audio input, right? So if you prefer not to use your microphone, you can just simply type the text and then feed into the avatar. So like I mentioned, behind the scenes is using our high quality neural text to speech model, as well as the customer neural voice model. So the avatar operate in two different modes. One is the batch mode. The other is the real-time streaming mode. So for the real-time, Think of that as like a two-way communications, right? While batch mode is a one-way communication, where the avatar will speak like to you, you cannot interact with the avatar. So if you think about the real-time avatar, it's best used for the customer service, the live chatbot scenario. So for example, you can build a chatbot for a travel website with the avatar like a user interface and like or virtual sales in a live commercial environment, right? So AI teachers who teaches online at the same time can also answer questions through the avatar. And then you can even build a virtual HR to answer questions from employees. And then the batch mode, which is like a one-way communication, right? So think of that as a training video, right? So like you have a training video of an hour, the avatar will be conducting the training video. Mm-hmm. And then also you could use a batch mode for a conference speech. And then for any leaders like CEOs, for example, doing a town hall, right? And then you could also use the batch mode for advertisement purpose as well.
So tell me a bit about using this responsibly.
So we take a Microsoft responsible AI principles very seriously because you can think of many use cases. Sometimes some of the use cases could be used in the wrong hands, right? So we do have a gating process. So the two offerings, the pre-built versus custom avatar, you do not need a gating form to use the pre-built avatar. But if you want to build your own custom avatar, we do require. So you go to an online form, right? And then fill that out. Once you do, so we're going to review use cases and then we'll get back to you.
I'm so glad, just if we could spend a second on this. I'm glad you're hold on, Seth, we got to do this responsibly because I was all like, all right, let's do this. And so what you're saying is that nobody can just upload videos of people randomly and then have them say stuff.
That's right. You have to
go through an entire process and it's vetted. And if people violate the terms, is it removed or tell me about that a little bit?
Yeah, so first of all, we have a list of approved use cases, like I mentioned earlier, right? So for the live chatbot, the customer services, or like a streaming scenario, like a town hall learning, right? So if the use cases, the user has fall into both categories, we can approve those use cases. But if it's not, we cannot approve. And then, of course, it's an ongoing basis. We have to make sure that you actually comply with what you showed in the application form.
Yeah, that makes sense. All right, so now I'm excited. Thank you for taking through the journey. I'm excited to see how it works.
Mm-hmm. There are two demos I'm going to show, right? So here you can see there's many of the capabilities from our Speech Studio. What I want to show you is one is the batch mode, right? So which is at the very end. So text-to-speech avatar. So if I click this, so here you can see, now it's already loaded. We have a couple of those pre-built avatar. Over time, we're going to add more gender and also ethnic diversities to our pre-built avatar selection. So for now, I'm going to select one of the avatars to show how you can just build something very quickly. So I'm going to select the second one, Lisa Graceful Sitting, right? So here you can see Lisa Graceful Sitting is right here. There are a couple of menus here, right? So you can basically switch to speech synthesis markup language mode. So I'll just use the pure text mode. So I'm going to enter something very simple. Here you can see, hello, my name is Lisa. Welcome to the Microsoft AI Show. It's a pleasure talking to all of you, right? So once I do that, I'll just click this button, preview video. So what's behind the scene, after I click this button was basically, this is sending the text, right, to the backend and then using the preview avatar I've already selected. So here you can see sometimes they take 8 seconds or 10 seconds. It also depends on the length of the text. So let me just play the video here.
Hello, my name is Lisa. Welcome to the Microsoft AI Show. It's a pleasure talking to all of you.
Yeah, so you can see that's the Lisa, the avatar was speaking using the text I just typed here. You may notice, right? So in between, Lisa actually had a gesture, right? So what about you want to add additional gestures? Wouldn't it be nice, right? So when Lisa was introducing herself, wouldn't it be nice that Lisa actually waves her hand, right? So If I put my cursor here, and then here you can see there's an insert gesture, right? So when I click, if I can scroll down a little bit, so you can see we have like a variety of gestures. That means for you to select. So I'm just going to select one of the gestures, like a wave here. So after I click that, you can see there is like a marker basically inserted in between the text, right? So now I can just do the same thing. I'm going to click preview a video, right? So like so, if we wait for another 10 seconds, so the avatar video will be ready.
So all right, wow, that was really fast. I was going to be like, let me say something so that it doesn't look like it's taking so long. And then boom, it's done. So what you're saying is that the SSML, because I know we kind of glossed over it, allows you to inject different kinds of things into the speech, including gestures and then also voice intonation, from what I understand. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
All right.
All right, so let me now play the new after video.
Hello, my name is Lisa. Welcome to the Microsoft AI Show. It's a pleasure talking to all of you.
So now you can see Lisa actually like waves, right? I mean, it's in her introduction. So this is just like a very simple example. So everything you see here is for the UI, right? So we built this UI for you to just test it out, right? So you can also select the different languages and also different voices specific to that language. And also here, we provide the code, right, for the developers. So we have some Python code snippet, right? And then also there's a link to the GitHub page that you can further look into. All right, so that's basically the battery mode, like a demo I want to show. So Seth, are you ready for the next one, which is live?
Yeah, so the batch mode makes sense to me, and it's ridiculously fast, and so that almost felt live to me. But I'm interested to see what you have cooking up for live mode, because that feels harder to do. But what do you got?
Yeah, absolutely. So let me go back to the speech studio. So here you can see there's a menu here, right? So it's a live chat avatar. So this is basically the UI experience we built for the user to experience how to interact with the avatars in real time. So there are two tabs here. The first tab is basically like a sample, like a video we have already pre-recorded. So in this case, it's basically using a friendly speaking style and also to be concise within like 25 words, right? So. But here, right? So I'm just going to the live mode. Let's try to something live.
And this is in the studio right now. People can try this out.
Yeah, absolutely. So after I click a try on your own, right? So it take a couple of seconds for the avatar to load. Seth, I just like a warning, right? So there's always a risk doing live demos. So let's see how this works. All right, so there are two ways you can interact with the avatar, right? So one is through the microphone here. The other is through this chat panel. So you can just type the text into it, right? So this chat panel also shows you the entire conversation history, like when you interact with the avatar. And then later, I will show you what the setting menu means. So now let me just click the microphone and then ask a couple questions. How are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you. How can I assist you today?
Can you tell me what is the Microsoft AI Show?
The Microsoft AI Show is a web series that covers the latest developments and news in the field of artificial intelligence.
That's true. That's true.
And who is the host of a Microsoft AI Show?
Seth Juarez is the host of the Microsoft AI Show.
Wow, Seth, looks like the avatar knows about you. So let me see how much he actually knows about you. Can you tell us more about the host of the Microsoft AI Show?
Sure. Seth Juarez is a seasoned AI expert, software engineer, and presenter. He has a PhD in education in the field of learning technology and is passionate about using technology to improve education. He is a regular speaker at tech conferences and also hosts the Channel 9 show Level Up, where he interviews software engineers, data scientists, and other tech experts.
Wow. So, Seth, I'm not sure if everything he said was true, right? So,
no.
But it's amazing. So,
not everything, but so, like, now that I'm seeing this, is this using like GPT-3.5 Turbo in the back end somehow?
Yeah, this is using the ChatGPT in the back end.
So, what's cool is that it's pretty close. But as I'm thinking about this, I'm like, of course, it got some things right. It got some things wrong. But the reality is that if you've seen other shows, you can probably hook up some pretty sophisticated retrieval augmented generation things in the back end so that it actually responds with grounded responses. But just this alone is pretty cool. Is there like a code? Like how does this work?
Yeah, I mean, so once I do the demo, I will show you the reference architecture. I mean, you can do something similar. And also, Seth, back to a point, right? So right now, it's a purely using ChatGPT. We have a service, Azure OpenAI, on your data, right? So which means you can ground the answers using your data, right? Enterprise data, the user's data. So you're absolutely right. I mean, you can use the avatar as the user interface, and then along with Azure OpenAI on your data. All right. So are you ready to try a couple of other questions?
Yeah, let's do it. I'm already blown away. This is cool.
Can you tell us when was the first episode of a Microsoft AI show?
The first episode of the Microsoft AI show was published on July 24th, 2017.
I don't know, Seth, was that right?
That feels right. I mean, because I've been doing this show for a really long time-ish.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
2017, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, so 6 years?
Yeah.
Holy cow. Maybe. Wow. I mean, that could really literally be the case. I'll have to go look. But again, it's just using ChatGPT, right?
Yes, that's right.
So this is awesome. Can you now, like, I know I'm pushing you here, but can I see like what this kind of looks like if to get started and the flavor of doing these kind of apps?
Yeah, so this is basically a reference architecture how you can implement something I just showed, right? So at the front end, this is basically you can use the microphone or using a text input. And then for the UI, there is this orchestrating layer, right? So basically orchestrating between the backend services from Azure AI. There's a speech to text service, right? So basically transcribe, what I just said into text and then feed it into the backend, which in this case is actually ChatGPT. And then the ChatGPT will respond back. And by the way, so we also have the options how to limit the responses from ChatGPT, right? So sometimes you want those verbose responses. Sometimes you just want concise responses. And then once the output is back to the text-to-speech module, you can see here the avatar, right? So basically it's inside the text-to-speech module. Making sure that means the avatar, the lip sync, right? I mean, will sync with the language the avatar will be speaking, and then get all the way back to the UI. So this is a very a high level, a reference architecture.
So this is amazing. You've kind of blew my mind, and I know I kept asking you for code, but I think we're going to do another episode where we actually get into actual code level stuff. Where can people go to find out more if they want to get started with this?
Folks can just go to our Azure documentation site, right? I mean, so we have a lot of different documentations. We also have a blog post that we can post online as well. So that blog post was basically we announced 3 weeks ago during Ignite. And also, if you have any questions, anyone has any questions, definitely reach out to us directly through this email address, which is avatarvoice@microsoft.com.
avatarvoice@microsoft.com. Thank you so much for being with us, Senyu.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Seth. It's a pleasure being here.
Also awesome. And thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about AI solutions with TTS Avatar and Azure OpenAI, my friend Senyu. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.
Yeah, thank you.